Welcome back to Dreamfall Chapters. It's time to go on some adventures with good old Crow and Markyria. This is gonna be fun.
I wish I had wings. I could just fly to the Purple Mountains. After I get some proper directions.
Is there a plan, or are we just winging it?
Ha ha ha.
Depends. Are the rebels still around?
I've heard mentions of rebels, yes, mostly preceded by cursing and followed by loud calls for slit throats and severed heads.
That's our plan, then. Find the rebels. Any idea where we can find the rebels?
I've only been back a couple of months and I've mostly been nesting, so no idea.
Great. Wait, nesting? Isn't that something only—
Stop! Let me stop you right there. And let's never speak of this again.
What's this? The Journeyman is closed, but all patrons and well-wishers are welcome at the Rooster and Kitten on Irede Avenue near Southgate. And here's a drawing of a rooster and a kitten, just to avoid any confusion, I guess.
That's right. A pussy riding a kitten on a cock. A rooster. Is it just me, or is that...
Not just you.
Good. Good. Good.
Well, this is as good a clue as any. To the cock and... the rooster and kitten, we go.
Come back, Crow!
This is crazy. I'm really, really here. And I remember it all. Well, I remember some of it. Things do look a little different. But, you know, wow. I'm back. And it wasn't a crazy coma dream after all. These pipes are everywhere. I'm sure they weren't here the last time around. I can tell from the etching that this man is dodgy. Honor Hilaris. What kind of name is that? A very dodgy name is what that is. They look shady. What did they do? Steal a magic hammer or something?
I have to say I'll be relieved when they're finally done with all this construction work. They've been building those tubes for years now, it feels like.
It's been about a year now, I think. Well, that's progress for you. Progress is never silent.
Really? Is that like an aphorism?
Must be. Sounds like it.
Well, I hope it's worth it, whatever those pipes are for. Am I the only one who thinks they're a real eyesore?
Progress is never pretty.
That is not an aphorism. No one ever says that.
They might. It could be.
Their hats look goofy. I like it.
It's connected to the pipes. Looks steampunky, very retro future. I can't even begin to guess what they're for.
Shame the magicals torched Old Town. But what did you expect? Those leeches wouldn't be happy unless they ran the city. And now they've been run out of the city instead. Good riddance.
I think you're the one that should leave, asshole.
Fear them, the enemy. For they are close. They are everywhere. I smell them.
I fit right in with the locals.
That foreign
smell. Nice thing.
Magic.
Good boy or girl. Hey, it's
it
soft.
Warms my heart to see
I thought it'd be hard, like a tortoise's shell.
Aww, big softy.
Nice thing.
Glory,
good
cousins.
Boy or girl.
Glory be upon you. In the light of the goddess.
I know I'm not really going the right way, but I kind of want to just see what I can get her to comment
front.
On.
I'm all for it. It's about bloody time we started taking control of the city back from the Azadi.
I agree. I mean, it's a shame about the magicals. The city feels emptier without them, but they're better off in the south with their own.
Markyria belongs to humans. The Northlands is no place for magicals. I have nothing against them, but I'd rather not have to be around them, right?
What?
Completely. Out of sight, out of mind.
I'm not a bigot, I just don't want to live around them because I don't like them. You know, nothing personal. Are they even hearing themselves speak? I'm just gonna go for a jog. Admire the wonderful walking and running animations in this game.
Are you saying the Magicals didn't destroy the ghetto?
Why would they do that? They were safe in there. Their homes, their businesses. Why would they burn that down?
Well, they're magical. Sorcery is unpredictable. It corrupts.
It does not corrupt. When did you first hear that? After the Azadi came. We had sorcery for thousands of years before that, and Old Town didn't burn down.
Well, actually, it did on a number of occasions. Mostly because of sorcery.
Yeah, fine. But those were unfortunate accidents. This was not an accident. The Azadi wanted all non-humans shipped off to their death camps.
Death camps? Now you're just being silly.
We'll see who's right when the truth comes out. And the truth always comes out in the end.
Well, at least not everybody believes the lies about the Magicals being sent off to... Well, what is the lie? I don't know what they're telling people, but they're definitely not telling people the truth, that they're actually being sent to death camps. But at least he seems to know about it. And if he knows about it, then it's probably kind of a... You know, something you can figure out if you do enough research or something. Or it's a rumor going around or something like that. Which is good. Alright, Crow, are you up here? Crow? There you are.
I have to admit, I'm quite relieved there's less sorcery about these days. Makes life a bit more predictable.
You don't know what you're saying.
I'm sorry?
That's like saying you're happy there's no more wind to make you freeze, or no more water to drown in.
How's magic comparable with wind and water?
Because magic is wind and water.
What's wrong with her neck?
Stars, stars and sound and
what
light.
What is wrong
light.
With her neck?
Magic binds everything together.
That looks really
without
uncomfortable.
Magic, there's nothingness.
Well, I'll be happier when there's no sorcery around to muck things up, is all I'm saying.
Were you even listening? Never mind. I give up.
There's something deeply, deeply wrong with that woman's character model. Ugh.
So what's your take on this Hilaris fellow? I keep seeing his face plastered all over town. Never heard of him before recently. Barrister, is he?
The National Front guy. On my honor. Anyone who wants to lead the City Guard that bad is up to no good. And I think he's being a little too harsh on sorcery in general. I mean, a little sorcery never hurt anyone, did it?
Doesn't even matter anymore, does it? There are barely any Magicals left. Yazardi have done a thorough job with that.
They're better off on the islands.
I've heard they've been relocated to the Southlands.
Even better. Out of sight, out of mind. They can live peaceably there with their own. Northlands for humans, I guess.
So, you're a National Front supporter?
Well, I suppose I am. Makes sense. Sure, why not? I'll cast my vote for Hilaris. He's probably a stand-up guy after all.
Are you actually going to cast your vote?
I doubt it. I mean, who has the time?
Sadly, that's far too many people's attitude about voting.
It's good to see tourists like yourself coming to the city despite the unrest. All that business with the Magicals. Shameful. That's not what this city is about.
I like listening in on people's conversations. Let's hear some more.
That's what they are. The emissary, that Raman person. Hilaris is one of theirs. A puppet on strings once he's elected.
It's the reaping. Can't we just enjoy the festival like normal people?
While the Azadi are plotting to enslave us all and destroy the world. Hardly.
The yams are particularly tasty this season.
Is that so? Can you recommend a particular stall?
There's this lovely rustic stall up High Hall, run by a very friendly farmer from...
Puppets. That's all we are. Filthy puppets.
Oh.
The Asadi remind me of the Eye. Fascist soldiers are the same everywhere, even across parallel dimensions. I feel better having Crow around, even though I'm not sure what he can do. Still, a useless sidekick is better than no sidekick. I'm not saying he's useless. So what have you been up to since I last saw you, Crow?
Like I said, after we parted ways, I woke up in Sidir. I have no memory of how I got there. I spent some time living wing to beak on the streets, disguised as a common cockatoo. That didn't go so well. I truly hate other birds, foul-brained tits. Eventually, I got help and found a ride back to Markyria. Then I moved into the Journeyman, then I met you, then we went off on adventures together. But enough about me. What about you? What have you been up to?
Coma, mostly.
That sounds nice. Was it nice?
Wouldn't recommend it, no.
Is that... Wait a minute. So this is part of the festival, right? The reaping or whatever? Is that dressed up as the mole people?
They're preparing for a shindig of some kind. Any celebration that involves burning large sacks of hay is guaranteed success in my book.
Kinda looks like it's dressed up as one of the mole people. Which at this point what's their name? The Banda? Bantu or something like that? And weren't they all exterminated except for the one that was just left in the city? Who I think she left, didn't she? That is actually the mole people, which have been almost entirely, if not entirely, exterminated, then it's in really poor taste to freaking burn a figure of those incredibly, well, that race of entities that have been just wiped out. Exterminated.
I must admit that I'm getting rather excited about seeing their newfangled tube network in action.
So when is this ceremony taking place?
Next week, isn't it? They're timing it to coincide with the Feast of Reaping. That makes sense. If they want us to celebrate the whole, switching the tubes thing.
What does that even mean? Does anyone know what they're for?
Well, they're supposed to make everything more efficient, right? Just more efficient, in general.
Make what more efficient, and how?
Well, efficient, like, I don't know. Why are you asking me? I'm not a bloody engineer. I'm just excited about the ceremony.
Keon had a description for this bush over here, and I wonder if Zoe does too. Can you tell me about this bush, Zoe? No description! I'm disappointed.
These pipes are everywhere.
I'm
sure they weren't here the last time around.
Zoe? There's no pipes there. I think there might have been some side effects from Zoe coming over, crossing over into this world. She's seeing things. She's hallucinating.
So, how's business?
Pretty good. I mean, reaping's a great time for me. Plenty of customers. Even if those farmers are tight-fisted, they bring their own food into the city.
They ought to do something about that.
How? I mean, farmers bring food into the city. That's what they do. That's, you know, their whole thing.
Yeah, but still.
No, that makes no sense at all. I mean, that's what the bloody reaping is all about. Farmers harvest their crops, bring the produce into the city, sell it, and come Reap Moon Eve, we all enjoy the Feast of Reaping.
I know, but is that what we really want from those peasants?
Well, yes. Yes, it is.
Whoop.
What can you tell me about Mercuria? What's changed?
Not much. They burned down Old Town. The Azadi have laid metal tubes everywhere. There are thousands of rats.
I noticed that. What are they for?
Tiny pets, I'd imagine.
Not the rats, the tubes.
Gymnastics?
I'm going inside. Wait for me.
What else can a free bird do? I need the open sky over my head. Or at least a proper hole in the roof. I'll be right here. Or over there. Where there's cheese and... Ooh, is that a bread crust? Don't look at me.
I'm not. I'm going in.
It's okay, Crow. Just be yourself.
Welcome to the Rooster and Kitten.
Hey. Greetings. Well, met.
What?
What? I don't know. I'm foreign.
You don't say. From where exactly? I'm a traveller myself, but I can't quite place the accent.
Well, given how sympathetic he is to the rebels, I'm sure he's not going to be too... angry about me being from other places.
I wish I'd taken those improv classes now.
Yeah. I don't know the geography of this place. What is up north?
I have no idea.
West.
Say something. West. Just back west. Far, far back.
What? Azadir?
Further left. West. Further west.
I didn't think there was a further west. I thought Azadir was as far west as west goes before it's east again.
Right. Well, you know, east, but by way of
Oh my
west.
God, she's terrible
that
at this.
That makes no sense to me, but then there is much that I haven't seen yet during my travels. What's this land named?
Ameri-Canada.
Ameri-Canada.
Yep. Home, sweet, Ameri-Canada.
So what'll it be today?
This is brilliant.
I'm sorry, what?
You know, you're not the first person confused by that question, even though, by all appearances, this is a drinking establishment. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. Is it my demeanor? Do I not appear appropriately barkeepish?
No, you're absolutely barkeepish. You exude publicanism. Drinks. What do you order in an old-timey tavern? There appear to be festivities going on in the city. When in Rome?
Yeah, something sweet and fruity. Would that fit with the festival?
What do you... There appear to be festivities going on.
I don't know, whatever.
Mead.
Mead?
No. Ale. Warm, dark, bitter ale, thick as porridge. In a metal chalice of some sort, suitable for drunken tossing.
You're sure about this?
Yes. I have been to an establishment such as this before. I know my ropes.
Clearly.
I really wanted a Diet Pepsi, though.
Are you certain you're in the right place?
Not at all.
Honesty. Ha! I like it. It's all too rare these days. From your attire and all of you, I'd say you're probably looking for a place up High Hall, not down here, dockside. This is a rough neighbourhood and you do stand out in my usual crowd of ne'er-do-wells, and standing out isn't always a good thing these days.
I'm certain this place has some connection with the Resistance. I should keep him talking.
Yeah, I'm in the right place.
No, this is my kind of place. I'm into dives. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to say that.
Oh, that's the nicest thing anyone said about my pub in a long time.
Really? Maybe it's a language thing.
So what else can I help you with, young lady?
I've only seen humans so far. They used to be blue people, furry people, non-human people. Where are they? This pub was not called the Rooster and Kitten the last time I was here.
Yeah, let's see what he says about the name change.
Didn't this used to be the...
Oh, the cock and puss. Someone's bright idea of a joke. Oh, we all get it. The cocky cockerel with a permanent frown on his face. Clever wordplay. Look at us, aren't we punny?
Yeah, wait, what?
I didn't approve. Too clever for its own good. But the painting of a tiny pussycat with a big smile riding on top of a proud capon. That idea I could get behind. It's sweet. It's sincere. It's family friendly. It's how I like my clientele to see me.
Is he being sarcastic? I can't tell.
Oh, there's some sort of festival going on. The reaping? I could use a primer.
Yeah, let's ask about the festival. I want to know what's going on at the festival.
I keep hearing about the reaping. Reap moon, feast of reaping.
I thought this was why you came to Mercuria.
Yes, I did. This is the reason for the coming to Mercuria, but... I didn't read the literature before booking everything and, well...
The reaping is the harvest festival. It's when the farmers bring their produce to the city markets. We celebrate this occasion with an entire month of reveling, culminating in the Feast of Reaping on Reap Moon's Eve. It's a giving of thanks to the earth and sky, the balance, the gods and goddesses, for providing food for the dark months ahead. And it's a fantastic excuse for eating and drinking as much as you can stomach.
I saw he mentioned something about a ceremony at the tower. What's the grand ceremony about?
It's the official unveiling of the tube network. I reckon it's where they'll tell us all about how things will be efficient in the future. The ceremony's taking place next week, on the day of the Feast of Reaping. The emissary probably thought it'd contribute to the celebrations. Won't make much of a difference to us Mercurians, to be honest. We'll still eat too much, drink too much, and pass out in the gutters when the sun rises. I mean, it's tradition, and tradition must be honored.
Especially the unhealthy ones that leave you with alcohol poisoning.
Oh, I've only seen humans so far. Where are all the magical races?
Oh, you don't know? Well, you are foreign. They've been, what's the word? Repatriated to their original homelands. It's for their own good. Mercuria's a human city now. There's really no need for sorcery anymore. Well, the magicals are better off in the south, I'm sure.
You don't sound convinced.
I am sure.
Obviously he doesn't actually believe that, since he was helping the rebels after all. But he's got to put on a face. He doesn't want to be a magical sympathizer. Because that'd probably get him killed, or just put in jail.
I saw some soldiers on my way here. I wonder if the Azadi still have a big presence in Mercuria. The Azadi are still running the city?
Oh, they're not. The council runs the city. The emissary is... She's an advisor. Her advice is invaluable. Of great value to all of us.
Sounds like a good arrangement. And the soldiers everywhere?
For our protection and benefaction. They keep us safe from enemies outside and inside. From rebel terrorists and the like.
You know, he's surprisingly not very good at lying. If somebody was here and, I don't know, kind of going in undercover to see whether he was a sympathizer and asking him these sorts of questions, I don't think they'd find his answers too convincing. You can hear the doubt and the disdain kind of just dripping off his voice, the insincerity.
I wonder why they're flying those kites above the city. If this place has a connection to the resistance, this man would know. Hopefully he won't kick me out if I ask. What do you know about the resistance? You know, rebels. Rebel movement. The magical insurgency? No?
We don't discuss terrorists here, madam.
Oh. Right, I'm sorry. I didn't mean... I was just curious.
Tell you what. There's someone you might want to talk to over in the smithy in City Green. It's on the far side, close to the gate into the bones. Go knock on the door. Tell them you're there to inquire about the library.
But now I'm afraid I have some work to do. I've been neglecting my other customers for too long.
Oh, I'm sorry. Thanks for all your help.
Who was that guy behind me? The guy with the glasses. And I always feel the urge to go upstairs just to see if there's something up here. Even if it's just an Easter egg or something. I feel like there's going to be something up here at some
Everyone
point.
Everyone should vote for Honor Illyris.
He seems like a slimy little toad to me.
He says a lot of smart things. The road forward is self.
So if there's any juicy conversations.
All magical. Have you paid your dues to Yaga yet?
The Wicker Witch of the North? I don't care much for childish superstition.
I wouldn't call her that if I were you.
You think she's listening? Here, in Markyria? Ha! Don't make me laugh.
Her tendrils are everywhere in the spirit world. Her magic is old, older than the balance, older than the twin worlds. You speak ill of Yaga, and someday she might speak ill of you. And when she does, you should just pay your dues on Reet Moon's Eve with the rest of the city. And pray that your name never passes her lips.
Okay, nothing particularly juicy up here.
Everyone should vote for Honor Illyris.
You already said that.
He seems like a slimy little toad.
The road forward is self-ruled in cooperation with the Azadi. No point trying to work.
Alright, visit the smithy in the City Green, near the bones. Where's the bones again? Is that around where the... I don't remember her name, the mole... like the mole mother or whatever she was? Is that around there? Was it the family of the guy that Keon killed... Mercy killed? Was that a smith? Smithy over there too? I don't remember.
I got a lead on the resistance. While I'm looking into that, there's something I want you to do. A mission.
Mission is my middle name. No, that's not true. It's Edward. Nope, also a lie. I just always wanted to be an Edward.
I need a bird's eye view of things.
Are you trying to get rid of me, Zoe?
Of course not, but I'll feel much safer if you're watching out for me up there while I'm following up on our lead down here.
I feel a swelling in my chest cavity that can only mean one thing.
Pride?
No. An imminent burp. But I will do this thing that you ask of me, and I will feign pride if you need me to.
Knock yourself out.
Geronimo! Except in reverse. A minareg.
I love you, Crow. You goofy bastard. Alright, the bones. Yeah, I think I can pass through here, assuming it's not closed off. Off to the right, I think. Oh. Well, judging by the wood planks over that doorway, I think it's closed off, isn't it? Hold on, there's a map right here. Alright, City Green is B. B. Which is... Oh, it's near Abnaxis's tower. Kind of like in the central place where I just went with the large haystack. That's gonna be burned? Yeah, okay. I don't mind jogging around this beautiful city for a bit.
So, how's business?
Pretty good. I mean, it's a great time. I must admit that I
have. Yeah, so it should be around here, huh?
Farmers bring food into the city, that's what they do.
If I'm not mistaken. Yep, looks like I'm right on it. Yep, this is the city green. Where's the smithy? Can I eat any of this food? Because it looks kind of delicious. Ooh, jams? Yeah, two different kinds of berries. I'm sure they're nothing I've heard of, but the one on the right looks kind of like raspberries, and the one on the left looks like, I don't know, it's orange. Never really seen orange berries before. Alright, perhaps this is the smithy over here? I mean, no, I assume it'd be more obvious, wouldn't it? Like a big... Oh, here we go. This has got to be it. Yep.
Nice thing. Good boy or girl.
I really want to yank on those flaps coming off of its face. I want to pull on them. If I did that, I'd probably get mauled to death, though.
There's no one home. This can't be the right door.
Maybe if you just knock a third time, they'll wake up. Maybe they're napping.
There's no one home.
Oh.
Hello, I'm here about the library. I know, it's a weird opener, but I was told that this is...
That's the guy that was behind me in the bar, in the tavern.
Okay, we're going inside.
Harmy knows.
Knows what, exactly?
That Kian is alive. And Shadow knows what else he told the General.
They spoke.
My men saw the General entering the engine room in the green. Alvani was spotted leaving the house soon after. They were alone in there with one of the engineers. Ferdows, I believe his name is. He's nowhere to be found. Harmy must have stowed him away somewhere. A witness!
So he knows that you've lied to him? Oh, he will not confront you with this yet. Not until he knows why and what we're planning.
Yes, Harmy is as clever as a rock snake and twice as deadly.
We need to get rid of him. Mother Utana, too. He must have told her.
They're thick as thieves. The only question is, have they informed the First?
Not without more evidence. There's still time.
You're speaking of assassination.
What else would you suggest? We crossed the line long ago, Vamon. There's no way back.
I can't just walk into Harmy's cell and cut his throat.
It needs to look like an accident. The ceremony.
It's a week from now. We can't afford to wait.
We can't afford to be hasty. Until he has concrete evidence of our treachery, the General will continue his investigations. The ceremony, then. We kill them both and make it look like the work of the Resistance.
But if he acts before then, I need to be ready. I need to inform those who are loyal to...
Hush. Come here, my sweet. Don't worry. We will survive this. We always survive. We've worked too hard to fail now. The engine will be ours. The Northlands will be ours. The General's men will pull back to Azadir. The Council will not mount another campaign. They cannot afford it. They lack the support of the people. And then we return in triumph, carrying the light of the Goddess, and we destroy our enemies. We rule Azadir, as we've always planned. We will not fail, my love. I will be Empress, and you, my supreme commander. This is the will of the Goddess. I know it is. I know it.
What is this place? Where are you taking me? Can someone please say something? You are the Resistance, right? You know, instead of abducting me, you could have just asked nicely. I would have come with you. I wanted to come with you. Not talking? Fine. Take me to your leader. I've always wanted to say that.
Shepherd's busy. She'll talk to you later.
So now you are speaking to me? Good. I'd like to... Wait, I remember that man, isn't that...
Stop talking. Keep walking.
But I know him.
Shut up.
Absolutely not. No. You cannot leave Mercuria now. If you go to Guillen...
What if they find you? They'll kill you.
So they kill me. I understand the risks, Eno.
I know you want to protect him, but he is one child. If you end up dead, what do we do?
You carry on. You're stronger now. You can fight them.
You know that's not true. The General has brought more troops from Azadir. Our situation is precarious.
I'll go with him. And make sure he stays alive.
What? You will not.
And we lose the both of you? We lost enough of our people when Old Town burned.
If Kian had done his duty, those people would still be with us.
If you'd listened to me, they'd still be with us. Torture isn't the only road to truth, Dalmari. Isn't that one of your sayings?
Boys, I'm as soft-hearted as a zidling schoolgirl, and Bip's my friend too, but I agree with Shepherd. We can't risk it.
It's not just about the boy. If I go to Guillen, to the camps, I will find evidence of what they're doing to the Magicals. And if General Hami and Mother Utana learn the truth of what's being done to innocent creatures, perhaps they'll...
Creatures?
He didn't mean it like that. Right, Kian? You didn't mean it like that.
He's shown that he doesn't consider Magicals to be people. We still remember that child-molesting Azadi officer you let go.
People. Women, children, the defenseless. If Hami and Utana learn the truth, they may have a change of heart. They may pull their support. We can't win this war on our own. Vamon and Saya are too strong. With Hami's men on their side, they'll be unbeatable. But if we undermine this support, even if Hami does not join our side, our chances will improve. Force me to stay, and we only delay the inevitable. Let me go, and we could win this war.
You don't make it easy for me to lead, Kian. But maybe it's time I let you make the decisions. I won't stand in your way.
I don't like this one bit. When are you leaving?
Right away. If I can sneak on board a cloud ship leaving for the islands tonight. Which means there's not a lot of time.
Well, don't let me stand in your way. Go be a hero or whatever.
Leave for Mercuria. Hey, once blind Bob, how's it going?
So, you're heading off on a little cruise across the sea, are you? I know Shepherd has her reservations, but I'm with you on this one, boy. We can try and preserve the status quo here for as long as possible, or... we can go and do something foolhardy and dangerous.
and maybe win this war. So, get your ass to Gien, save that boy, find the evidence, and come back with your limbs intact. Or at least most of them. And let's end this thing, once and for all.
Sounds good. I mean, honestly, it's kind of true. The rebels really do kind of need to take risks if they want to have any hope of actually really making any real change. They're just too weak in general to be able to actually get by just on sheer force alone.
So when is your shepherd gonna talk to me? I don't need to be locked up like this. I'm not an Asadi spy. Forget it. It's a long story. What's the point? You don't make the decisions. This is a waste of everyone's time.
Normally, I'd join in
every
questioning,
minute I spend here
but
is
I
another
don't have
minute
the time.
Lost trying to save the world. I mean,
oh, I can't go in.
Whenever we bring someone in, they're questioned in there. If they refuse to answer, they're brought downstairs. Not everyone's comfortable with the screams.
He's not going to go inside, is he?
Normally, I'd join in the questioning, but I don't have the time now.
Okay. Alright, I guess I shouldn't stop to talk to everybody because I am supposed to go, so let's go. Maybe I'll stop to talk to you, though.
You're not leaving without me.
You're needed here, Liko.
Those prisoners? They are my people.
Imprisoned by mine. This is almost certainly a suicide mission. If the Resistance loses us both, they stand no chance against the Tower.
If you die, I will celebrate your death.
Gee, thanks.
But I will never be their leader. You've proven yourself. They need you. Go. And stay alive. For them. For all of us.
You still plan to kill me after?
Of course.
Well, I wouldn't want to miss that.
I think with a little more work, Liko and me can be best buds. That animation looks so awkward.
They're bringing magicals through that gate and onto the cloud ship. That cloud ship's headed to Gien with a new batch of prisoners. I must get on board.
Yeah, they just took a huge batch of magicals up there right now, it looks like. Alright, well, I think this is a pretty good place to end the episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far. And when I return, I'm gonna attempt to sneak on board that cloud ship.